Good evening. Preparation for the Holy Communion. Our church has come from a long tradition where preparation for the Holy Communion plays an important role. First, just a warning that preparation for the Holy Communion should not be detached from constant life in humility and self-examination before the Lord. Yet, this does not mean that we should not prepare ourselves specifically for the celebration of the Lord's Supper. Paul explicitly wrote about this preparation in 1 Corinthians 11:27-31. Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and the blood of the Lord. A man ought to examine himself before he eats of the bread and drinks of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without recognizing the body of the Lord eats and drinks judgment on themselves. That is why many among you are weak and sick, and a number of you have fallen asleep. But if we judge ourselves, we would not come under judgment. The Lord's Supper may not be used unworthy. Communion, according to the revelation of the Lord to Paul, has a certain value, a deep value, in the sense that Holy Communion is nothing but a commemoration of the crucifixion of the Lord for the sake of his people. It has great value. It has so much value that Paul does not hesitate to say in Philippians 3 that it is only the only valuable thing. To use it with dignity, to use it to value, requires preparation and self-examination. The word used for self-examination refers in another context to the examination of or testing of the authenticity of metals. The believer must test himself. He must determine whether his view of and his use of the sacrament is genuine. Do I value the Lord's Supper? Do I realize that it is about the death of Jesus Christ on the cross? That his blood was shed and his body was broken because of my sin? I need to be able to distinguish between the Lord's Supper and the regular meal. Communion is not about the physical nourishment, but about the deep spiritual nourishment with the body and the blood of Christ. Those who do not do so should not partake in the communion. Otherwise, Paul says, he eats and drinks judgment on himself. You put yourself before the judging Lord, and you are guilty of the body and the blood of Christ. You then participate in the underestimation of the body and the blood of Christ. You despise it and discredit it. You despise and discredit Jesus himself. You draw a line through the great deed that Jesus did on your behalf. A further consequence of unworthy use of the Lord's Supper is that it also has consequences for fellow believers. Paul links the unworthy use of the Lord's Supper by the Corinthians to the chastening hand of the Lord. He declares that the dissension that arises in an unworthy use of the Lord's Supper is the reason why there are so many sick people and dead people among them. He sees it as in the Lord's chastening hand that will prevent them from finally sharing in the condemnation of the word of the world. The unworthy use of the Holy Communion therefore has tremendous consequences. And it is from this that the custom in our churches arose that the elders, for the sake of the members themselves and for the whole congregation, take co-responsibility over who uses the Holy Communion. A closing word, through preparation and inquiry, should never result in me not using the communion with confidence. On the contrary, whoever thinks about the value of communion, whoever realizes that he is not worthy for using the communion out of himself, but only through Jesus Christ, he will participate in the meal with boldness and eagerness. Good night.